open a magazine without getting a glimpse of her face. Besides, she showed the whole world that not every pop star has to look like Britney, who came to New York City to get exposed with Avril Lavigne.
It's so weird when people are like, oh, you're a celebrity now, and I'm just like, it's too weird to like hear people call me a celebrity or say that I'm famous. It doesn't feel like it. I got a wig and it's blue. Whenever I want to go out somewhere and like go shopping or whatever, I'm like, I'm not getting like some ugly brown wig or whatever. I'm like, I'm getting a blue wig. If I'm gonna wear a wig, it's gotta be cool. Usually what I do is I just tie my hair up and put it on top of my head and put a hat, huge hat over my face, and it still doesn't work.
Like, I've come into this accepting that people are gonna say like good things and bad things about me, and I don't go around like reading the press and stuff, because I honestly don't want to hear what people have to say about me, because I don't really care, because I'm just doing my thing and I'm happy with what I'm doing, so I don't like worry about it.
He's going to get vegetarian food.
We're starving.
Stomach hurts.
Yeah, Matt and I went out partying hardcore the night before. It was one of those nights where night turned into morning so quick, and before we knew it, it was lobby call. So it was like from the party to the lobby. So we had no sleep last night.
Party to the lobby.
So Alec, how did you like Mexico City?
I hated it.
I still have the shits. It's been a week now.
It was way too scary to jump on skates for Skater Boy. Me and Evan were afraid that shit was gonna fly.
during
this is a non-jumping show.
During my world, I was like, it was building up, and we kept going. I was like, oh my god! I felt like the girl from Willy Wonka, the blueberry. She starts floating.
Okay, Evan, you just lost about 15 girl fans right now. Yeah. And it's going up by the minute. Keep talking.
I need some food!
Yes, a cafe.
We're checking out the food choices here.
What are you
thinking? We got a sunshine burger platter. Kind of interested in that. We'll see how it goes over.
What did you say? Hey, if you want, I will split this with you.
Okay.
What do you get? I got this. It's a veggie burger.
Okay.
And if you get something, then you split it with me.
I'll have the vegetarian pumpkin soup. And I'll have tomato and basil wing.
Did they just bring that orange juice?
Yeah, you want some?
Have you been drinking it?
Oh, yeah, it's mine.
It's mine. No, I just ordered orange juice.
All right, let's fight over it. Come on.
Do you guys have to take your alone time? Do you need, each everybody needs their own personal space?
I don't take too much alone time. Not really. I'm a very, like, people person. Everybody, I like being around people.
A bit of a long time.
When I have so much excitement going on all the time, when it's like, okay, go to your room and sit there alone, it's like, I can't handle that.
We just have a lot of fun together, I think. Everything we do, we at least, even if it isn't fun, we make it fun. So, like we're saying, everyone needs a little bit of alone time, but for the most part, we just have fun.
I must say, these are the most ridiculous bags on the planet. Supposedly, they're like $150 for this.
This is my makeup bag.
What is this?
Looks like a pencil case.
It's a makeup bag.
Does it come with makeup?
It could be a pencil case.
Yeah, it better come with makeup.
Did it come with makeup?
For the price.
I don't really ever sit down and sit and think about everything that's happened. But the other day, it hit me. I was like, oh my god. I was just flipping the channels and I saw like my face on TV and I was like, I'm famous. I really am. It doesn't feel like it.
Is there anybody, have you met anybody who's been
Adam Sandler?
I was just gonna best say person. That. I was just gonna say that.
Adam
Sandler. He's exactly how he is in his movie. Yeah.
Yeah, but Leno was cool.
That's cool.
Yeah, Leno was cool.
Leno
was
called me a dork.
Leno called you a dork?
Yeah, Leno's
he's only speaking the truth.
I showed him a magic trick.
Jay Leno is like the nicest one out of all the guys, all the late night show guys.
Actually, we can't say that because we haven't met Conan yet.
Fuck, Kilmore could have been a lot nicer.
These are dirty secrets from Avril Lavigne and the band.
Yeah.
Sometimes when I'm like in a store or whatever and someone says my name, I'm like, how does that person know me? I'm like, oh yeah. I totally forget, like, all the time. I don't think of myself as being famous. I just think of myself as the same person that I was when I lived back in Appanee.
The problem is when you actually realize it. Like, I remember at Radio City, like, halfway through Complicated or something, like, you know what I mean? Every once in a while, you'll snap into reality.
You just
like,
screw
like,
just like
I'm playing at the VMAs live.
A million people watching this right now.
And then you start looking. You can't remember the notes. You can't remember anything. Yeah. You're like, oh, Cool. Like the first time we played Leno, I remember it was like right when we came in, it was like.
Dude, things never hit me. Things still haven't even hit me. It still hasn't even hit me that I have a record deal.
It's just gonna hit you really hard then.
Yeah, you're gonna, well, you're gonna be like 30.
Are,
like,
wait, are you paying attention to everything that's going on?
Not really.
No?
People, like, you know, let me know you're number one or whatever.
So Complicated is doing all right.
But I don't really care.
Yeah. I think he's sold like 5,000 or something. Yeah. Yesterday, actually.
awesome. Are you vegan?
No. Just vegetarian.
So you cheese?
Yeah. I would like to be vegan. It's just really hard right now, considering.
You don't have to be a vegetarian. You can just cut down your meat intake. Do you eat it like once a week?
Uh-oh.
I mean, no.
Who took my ginger ale? Matt! Mine. That was mine. She just brought me a new one.
She brought it for me.
I asked her for a ginger ale. Okay? Oh.
I thought you just saw that. My drink?
No, you didn't ask. I was the one who asked.
She just saw that mine was empty.
Did you guys graduate high school?
I bailed out of school. I was supposed to go to college. Never did.
You love playing so music. Smart. You're taking a bigger gamble going to school.
Yeah, I dropped out of high school.
The whole time, all I wanted to do was play.
I thought, like, usually, don't they, like, get someone on the road to, like, two?
You don't travel with your folks, do you?
No, of course not. Everyone always expects that.
We're all each other's
folks.
So
many people do, man.
No way, man.
So many.
My parents came on the road with me. They're f***ing psycho right now. It's horrible.
It's such a crazy lifestyle. It's just, like, so unpredictable. You don't know what's going to happen, and that makes it so much fun. I feel like I wouldn't need time off for, like, 5 years. I love it. Because I'm that type of person who needs, like, I need a lot of action and a lot going on in my life because I get really bored easily.
The first time we were going to go to Europe, 4 hours before we were going to go to Europe, we got kicked out of a hotel.
Our tour manager got arrested.
You can't say we got kicked out of the hotel. You guys slept peacefully in your bed. I'm on the sidewalk with my bags.
You put up a fight. You're like, please cops. Cops. While the cops are standing right there, I'm like, dude, you're going to get arrested. Remember just hearing you cursing as they're leading you down the hallway? It's like, and like 10 minutes later, my phone rings. He's like, yeah, I'm out on the curb. I'm not allowed back in the hotel.
Did that happen a lot?
No, unfortunately.
You guys fly first class?
No.
Some of
us. Avril gets first class. We get economy.
You can't just sit there and say that. You have to understand why. It's so that, like, if I'm sitting back there with you guys, that's everyone, all the whole entire flight's going to be like,
you won't get any sleep. That's true.
Yeah, no, honestly, like, There's always a ruckus when we get on the plane. There's always people running around.
Two flights ago, the stewardess walked by and she tried to impress us. She goes, hey guys, did you know Avril Lavigne's at the front? And like, him and Evan and Jesse played it up so good. They're like, well,
I was like, can I get her autograph?
I set the note up. I signed it. Like, what do I put on it?
I love you so much. Kiss,
can
Jesse.
I have your autograph, Jesse? I made the stewardess go up and give it to her.
And she gives
it
back to me.
She's like, I don't know if she'll bring it back to you. I don't know if she'll sign it, but I gave it to her.
She comes to me, she's like, there's some kids that just wouldn't stop bugging me back there.
She was so pissed.
They want your autograph.
We get bored. That's how we waste our time.
Yeah.
Joke. Bugging me. Up in first class.
Ooh, first class.
Yeah, I have a nice reclining chair.
Your family life, was it like a stable, solid unit and then just always very supportive of what you did?
Yeah, my parents, ever since I got my deal, they've never been on the road with me. I guess just because they know my management and trust them, and they know that it's my life. It's like, you know, I need my space now. They understood that it was like something that they didn't need to be there for. You know, it's me making my music and playing my music. I didn't need their help with that, which is hard for them to let me go, but they have their own lives back at home, and this is my life.
Coming up, shopping with Avril and the band.
I wouldn't call her stylist. I call her personal shopper because I can't go out to mom, okay?
And things start to get a little heated.
Matt, you're gonna piss off our lead singer.
We never fight. We get along really well, and, you know, we're always there for each other.
All coming up on
As vegetarian shoes.
Oh, no way. Yeah. The vegetarian shoes?
Yeah.
I've been looking for, like, the ones from the UK.
Yeah.
I've been looking for those for so long.
Do you get a chance to do a lot of that, like, fun stuff on a daily basis?
Well, not too often, but we try to as much as we can.
These are so you. This looks like that outfit you were wearing last night.
X-Man on me, yeah.
Oh, sorry.
I have a coat like this at home. I bought it, and then Matt had to go out and buy one and copy me.
Okay, let's talk about who had the idea to get it first.
Okay, what do you...
And then who went and got their stylist to get them one.
Excuse me?
This is like the
okay, first
class
of all, I wouldn't call her stylist. I call her personal shopper because I can't go out to a mall, okay? You wear Gork model shopping? That was just bad for Matt to just even say that.
Matt, you're gonna piss off our lead singer.
They know how much I hate that. They're like, okay, every artist has like a stylist, but it's like, for me, it's not like that person styles me. They just go out and get me the clothes. Like, I'm like, can you go get me like a pair of black Dickies? Or can you get me a tank top? Or can you get me a new pair of Converse? Since I can't go out and do that. First of all, I don't have the time. Second of all, I can't go shopping. Period.
I like shit.
Oh, always stepping on the wrong toes.
You guys all really rely on each other?
Yeah, we never fight. I mean, we have like a little like sister brotherly fights, you know, but that's it. We get along really well and, you know, we're always there for each other. And it's really cool what we have.
I don't like it. I just don't like this.
Well, what if it was this tight? Would you like it then?
Yeah, I think I should get a pair of these. What do you think?
Oh, wow.
There we go. Shauna.
Get those off. Those are hideous.
Wait. How do you handle it when people say no to you for something?
I like the dead honest truth. If someone says no, it just depends on what they're talking about. They're saying, no, you can't wear that shirt because it says f*** you. I'm going to say, yes, I'm going to wear it.
You've had that conversation before?
conversations like that, yeah.
Where are these vegetarian shoes everyone's talking about?
It's all in this order, I don't care.
Oh, wow. Av! See, these are vegetarian shoes.
Really?
They're not leather.
I don't really have beef with leather.
Oh, that's
my
nice.
Joke. Charlie used to be vegan.
Yeah. He's coming off it.
Yeah.
You're a vegetarian, sort of.
I don't eat meat.
You're red meatless?
I don't eat meat or fish, so.
Why not?
Because it's gross. And because it's really bad for you.
So it's more health and that, as opposed to animals and...
Yeah, that's cool. Right.
Me, I'm the opposite.
You're the opposite.
Well, it's
the
just
opposite.
Like, animals came first, then health. And I was like, 2 years down the line, I'm just like, vegetarian, that is a lot healthier. I mean, I realize that
you can freak your shit out though if you don't balance properly, right?
Oh, I know. If you're gonna be vegetarian, you gotta go about it the right way. That's for sure.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. I love these. Do you like these shoes? They're so weird. Charlie? Can I get some?
Those are awesome.
Matt, you gotta get a pair. Maddie. I never buy my own stuff. It feels weird. I'm like all like picky. I'm like, wait, do I really want to do this? Okay, I'm gonna get them.
Alright. What do you think? They're better?
That looks good. Yeah. I like this skirt. Looks too big though. I could hem it. I don't wear skirts. What am I doing? I'm not like super like, oh my god, my legs look fat in that picture or whatever. I'm not like that, but I do. I'll admit, I do sometimes go, oh my god, I'm getting fat or whatever. Or, oh, like, crap, I have a zit on my face. But I mean, that's just normal.
Okay, I missed it. I was looking at his skirt.
Yeah, it works on you. I think you do it.
Feels good.
I think you can pull it.
What do you think?
You can definitely.
I like it.
Yeah.
You buy the hat, I buy the skirt.
Done.
And we'll hook up with you guys tomorrow.
Excited about your team pieces? I don't even know what the hell it is. I think it's like 3 songs, 4 songs.
It's supposed to be 3 songs, but you've got a total of 18 minutes.
See you tomorrow.
If you want to do more, you can. It's up to you. We're doing Skater Boy.
In that hat too.
Skater Boy, Losing Grip, Complicated, and Unwanted.
Perfect.
Cool. All
right. There you go. We'll see you tomorrow. Okay, Avril Lavigne's about to perform a very special, intimate show for a group of very excited kids.
And if you could only let it be, you will see.
We just performed at the Musicians on Call thing here at the hospital.
Fall back, take a look at me, and you'll see I'm for real.
When they asked me to, I was like, yeah,
I'll definitely do it. But like when we came in here today, it was just kind of like weird because like hospitals freak me out. I just expected like kids in their pajamas. I didn't expect every kid to be in a wheelchair and have like, you know, needles in their legs and like crazy stuff going on. So it's definitely shocking. And I was just like, whoa. Turn me into something else. It's easy to see I'm not down with that. I'm not nobody's fool. It's definitely, you know, I'm not used to singing in this sort of like environment, but it felt really good, and it's something that I'd like to do some more. And it's especially really cool because like I got to like talk to the kids after and meet them. I've never performed for a room full of sick children before. So it's different. So here's me gonna finish it up with one more song.
Skater Boy.
Sing it. Do you guys know Skater Boy?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll do it. He was a boy, she was a girl. Can I make it any more obvious? He was a punk, she did ballet. What more can I say? Oh, she's been made up by the record label, which is complete like bullshit. I write my own songs, and anything that comes out of my mouth is like what comes from me, and like I do and wear and write and say whatever I want to. Yeah.
Do I have to go out on that thing?
You don't have to,
no. No, do I have to tonight?
People say that when you get famous, you know, the fans or the friends will say that person changed, but more often than not, I find out that it's not you who changes, it's the people around you who change.
That's totally true. When I go back home, everyone's kind of weird around me, and it's like, it's just totally not the same, and they don't really, a lot of them don't accept me. It's more them than it's me. I'd love to just go back home and just like go to parties and party it up with them, but they're the ones who'll be all weird around me.
Is that hard to have that part of your life missing?
It sucks a lot, because I go back home and it's like too bad I can't just like go hang out with a bunch of people. But yeah, it sucks. But there's like, that's kind of like a consequence, like what comes with the territory. And my personality has confidence. Yeah, I guess you could say that. I'm not always confident in everything, but most stuff that I do that I believe in and I go out and do, I have full confidence in.
Is this fun for you, this kind of stuff?
How's this going?
No point in even starting the interview until Avril's here. I get it, George.
No, we're talking to you. I don't want to talk to you.
Here we go. You know who you really want to talk to.
Tell us what's going on over here.
You're just the nicest guy on this whole road. They basically just yell at you the whole time. It sucks.
A lot of Avril over here. Avril over here.
Everybody over here. Avril.
What do you guys trade off? Cameras there?
Let's trade of cameras.
What's going on here?
Is this still weird? Is this weird? For you, does this ever get normal?
This is the first one where I've kind of been bored.
Practicing my camera.
That's right.
Jesse's actually full-fledged interviewing the rest.
Where are you from?
Channel 11 WB.
Hi, how's it feel to be here?
How are you?
It's nice to see some familiar faces.
No, that's good. This is where it becomes work, doesn't it?
Yeah, this is the weird part. It's fun, though. I mean, red carpets are crazy, but wherever there's a red carpet, there's an after party.
When people get out there and start, you know, bringing out your name, Avril, do you ever just kind of tune everybody out, tune in your own?
Totally. Yeah. I mean, I do tune everybody out. I can't sit there and be like, oh my God, this is happening. Oh my God, what's happening? I just stand there and I'm just like, okay, this is work. This is what I have to do. So I'm just going to sit there, stand there and smile, look at everybody, and it'll be over with.
This is part where you almost feel uncomfortable because it's like, all right, it's just about photos now. Nothing to do with music. It's just photos.
Yeah. It's really weird.
She's hot. She's got that attitude, and she don't take nothing from nobody. She's like the new Cyndi Lauper.
Do you think you're, even though it's different than your friends, do you think you're not missing anything? Do you think you're growing up and the way you need to grow up?
Yeah. I don't feel like I'm missing anything. The only thing I really feel like I missed was prom.
Give it up to the coolest thing to come out of the Canada, Avril Lavigne!
When was the last time you cried?
3 nights ago? Because Matt hit me in the face. No, I'm joking. I think I just got really edgy just from traveling. It was just like, I can't take this anymore. And sometimes you just get those days where you just like have to cry and you have no reason to cry. But that's okay. That's when Evan's room and he hugged me and I cried and I felt better and said, okay, bye.
Do you have an idea of the bigger picture of what you're going through and what's coming?
Yeah, I know that I'm going to come out with like a couple more albums, and then I'll probably take a couple years off and get married and get a house or whatever, and then go back out and keep doing it. That's what I think will probably happen.
And do you want to get married?
For sure. I'm just like that hopeless romantic, you know. I'm gonna get married and have kids one day. I don't know when that'll be. But
have you met the person yet?
No.
Do you get to maintain any of that boy stuff on the outside?
No. It's not now. Not right now.
All in due time.
Yeah, I guess. You can't relax, you're charming every fool. You're looking like a fool to me. I know that a lot of people do understand that I'm coming out as myself and I'm not made up by the label and stuff like that. And like, I'm honest with my lyrics. I say whatever I want to say and whatever. A lot of people get that, but a lot of people don't. So it's just, you know what, that's just the way it's going to be. Some people are going to get it and some people aren't. Anyone who's has a lot of good things being said about them, some other people have to jump in and say bad things automatically. If someone's on a pedestal, people, that, like, just for that simple fact, just because they're up there, people just want to bring them down, and that's all part of it. And that's, you know, I'm aware of that, and no matter what, that's going to happen, so whatever. It doesn't really bother me. I don't really care.
Gets me frustrated. Life's like this, you fall and you crawl and you break and you take what you get and you turn it into honesty. Promise me I'm never gonna find you fake it. No, no, no. You come over unannounced, dressed up like you're something else. Where you are ain't where it's at. You see, you're making me laugh.